time for What's the Buzz, everyone. And today, we are talking all about the gym.
Yeah.
That's right. So joining us are John Jordan, our style editor, Jody Treeweiler, fitness expert and personal trainer at the Beverly Hills Club, and Marlon Page, a technology strategist and founder of Sisters Code. Thank you for being here.
We invited you because we want you to help us pick things up and put them down. So let's talk about this. When you're in the gym, sometimes there's a line that gets blurred. This is men and women. Mm-hmm. It's not just about outfits, right? It could be, but it's also about the caliber of people working out. Are you getting intimidated? Lots to talk about.
Right.
And should it be left up to individuals? So when it comes to dressing, we've got comfort level to deal with.
Yeah,
sports bras, right?
Yeah.
Your Lemon Lulu looking thing. Well, you come in every, this is the first time you walked in and you said to us in the control room, I'm dressed in real clothes today.
Right.
Because you're always dressed for a workout.
Being in the gym, you see it all. I see everything that's going on. You know, a lot of gyms actually have dress codes. So everything you're seeing on social media and those pictures of people and all the little tiny outfits doesn't really happen a lot in the gym, actually.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I think, I don't know, what do you think about the skimpy outfits?
Well, I think that in the gym, it's one thing. I think the worst offenses occur on the street by people who think that what's appropriate for the gym somehow transitions throughout the rest
of
their day.
Oh, interesting. Right. Okay.
Very We've
true.
All seen that, right?
Yeah. Absolutely. Absolutely. Here, well, here's a picture to kind of illustrate what you should be doing, not walking out with the crop.
Well, right. And there are people who, especially like, you know, I'm sort of back and forth to California, and I see a lot of that on the West Coast. It's like,
but it's warmer, too, so what if it's July? Can you walk out looking like that? Is that still not okay?
I don't find it to be appropriate out in public with a half top on.
Yeah.
I wouldn't do it. And sometimes the young girls are wearing like the prom dresses, the half top thing, but walking out in a sports bra, I don't like to see it.
Yeah.
I definitely wouldn't do it.
I wouldn't do it either.
Yeah.
I mean, no, this body could not. The world couldn't handle that.
In a good way.
Because we're
going to
be positive.
Listen, let's slow down. Don't kill
them. The world couldn't handle that.
Could I look amazing? But, yes, but I'm not going to.
Let's not just beat up on, you know, one sex here. Because men are offenders, too. You know, the guys with the, you know, gaping.
Like this guy right here,
and,
perhaps?
You know, like if you have a great body, I'm really happy for you, but.
I like to see those muscles.
That's,
I know.
If it's in a gym, that does not affect
me. But not on the street.
But if it's in front of me at a store, weird.
That's a problem.
I think it's sort of a scream show off.
Wait a minute.
It does a little bit.
If I might,
in a workout area.
He needs to see the serratus muscles.
You
are
know?
They there?
Just because you're talking technical
a little bit?
Yeah.
Does not make it real. So is it okay then? Could we see ladies? What kind of muscles are they?
The serratus.
Those.
Right on the side.
Exactly.
Can we see, is that okay?
For a woman?
Yeah, in a gym.
If there's a sports bra under it and an overlaying tank top, that's actually a really big style right now.
And if I had that, I'm showing it.
But you know what John was pointing to is not just about that was a specific style statement. There are the guys who just cut a big giant hole, you know, on the side of their gray t-shirt.
Yeah. And then, you know, there's the guys who picks their shirt up and dab their face to make sure you see the 8-pack underneath there. I mean, people do go a bit far at times in gyms and
workout settings. Well, those are the same people who have shirtless profile pictures on social
media. You go. Thank you.
I think it's great if you look great, but needy isn't attractive.
Exactly.
But there are people who are looking for them. That's why they keep doing it.
That's true. It works somewhere, right?
Some people are going to the gym to pick people up and to be picked up.
Yeah, and we're
going
to get to that in just a second. But how do you address inappropriate outfits in the gym? Muscle heads, or how about people who might have a little gentle aroma going on? Do you say something?
Well, it's a gym.
I've been in the gym countless hours.
Yeah.
You can't change other people, nor is it your job to.
Right.
You can only change where you're standing,
mm-hmm.
who you're standing by, where you're working out.
Mm-hmm.
I've been next to some people that stink, like, nauseatingly so. Just move.
Yeah.
Okay.
Really? Because are you going to sit there and stew about it? Or, hey, change your outfit. Just go away. Look away. Right. Avert your eyes.
I wouldn't say anything.
Too.
Bring
you know,
to
that's
management.
That's what
that's
management's
great,
for.
That's a great suggestion.
Wait a minute, run to the guy at the counter and say, this guy right here stinks?
Yes.
You know, I wouldn't hesitate to do that. Like,
wow.
Don't you think that's just sort of a polite society?
Yeah.
You know,
I would say nothing.
You wouldn't say anything, Marlon?
I wouldn't say a word.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
No.
You would just move on?
I would move on.
And when you talk about muscle heads, you know there are the times of the day or the times of the week. Saturdays, it's the guys that are all, you know, and they've got to walk around and bench press 300 pounds. And it's not the time for mere mortals. And that's an intimidation factor. When I think a lot of people who are trying to look trim aren't even going because they don't look trim, so they don't go.
That's why your outfit, you know, it, you need to make great choices in terms of what you're wearing. If you don't have a perfect body, there are all kinds of tricks. You know, black is still very slimming. You don't have to wear skin tight. You can wear, you know, a top that's fluid. There are all kinds of tricks that are forgiving of figures. And the key is to not feel bad about yourself or you won't go to the gym.
Right, because it's more about you wanting to be comfortable with the way that you look, and that will make you have a better workout.
Sure.
Right. So let's talk about this then. Gyms as a social setting, and sometimes people feel comfortable enough to come up to you and maybe try to, you
pick
know,
you
pick you up, get a date, Marlon. What do you think about that?
I think it's ridiculous. Mm-hmm. It makes me mad. If I get up and I go to the gym, I made the effort, don't talk to me. Like, don't. I have headphones in, leave me. Leave me alone.
I actually
quit a gym because it had become a social hangout.
Yeah.
And so I said, I can't go here anymore. I didn't complain about it. I just left and moved my membership.
But when you're holding that 15 or 20 pound dumbbell, it's hard for people to come up to you. Boom.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I think I'm kind of cute and everything, but
she's
like this guy,
like that right there,
like that right there.
She hit on the headphone thing. You have to have headphones on. That is a sign socially to people. I don't want to be disturbed. And if honestly, I didn't wear headphones, no less than 15 people wanted to chat, and not necessarily even hitting on me. But people don't usually have a ring on.
Right.
So that's another problem while you're at the gym. Nobody knows who's married.
Right.
Keep the headphones on. And if someone tries to talk to you, you just give them a little point. Can't hear you.
Right.
And that's it. Don't start the conversation.
I like all the attention I can get anywhere.
You're the sweetest.
That's why we put you in the first seat.
We're in showbiz and I just own it. So.
Well, thanks guys for being with us. Jason, over to you.